Hallelujah. May peace be with every brothers and sisters.
Hallelujah. 愿大家平安。
Tonight, the topic for our sermon is prayer that changes your fate.
今天晚上我们要与大家分享的是改变命运的祷告。
Your fate is your future.
命运就是你的未来。
And how do we know our future?
那我们要如何知道未来呢？
We don't know our future.
我们并不知道。
But our future is being shaped by every single decision that we are making every day.
不过未来就是由我们今天每天的选择当中所堆砌出来的。
If you make the right decision, your future is going to the brighter and better direction.
如果你一直都是做着正确的决定，那你的未来肯定是光明美好的。
On the opposite, if you make wrong decision all the time, then your future is getting worse and worse.
反过来说，如果我们今天老是做一些错误的决定，那我们的未来就会越来越走下坡。
Sometimes when you face difficult situation,
有时候我们遇到很困难的情况。
Next line tell us, what will you do when you face difficulties?
那时候你会怎样面对它呢？
That is a big question.
这是一个很重要的问题。
Recently, we study the story of David in the Bible.
最近我们在圣经里面读到大卫的故事。
He was facing a very dire, very difficult situation.
他是在面对人生非常困难的时刻。
And then he was about to face a very tough situation, very tough future.
而且同时也在面对的一个严峻的未来。
But how can he change his future?
不过他要如何去改变那个未来呢？
Through one prayer, his life, his fate is totally changed.
通过一个祷告，他的命运就此改变了。
So prayer can change everything.
所以祷告可以改变一切事，
including your own future，
包含着你的未来。
Now let's look at what kind of situation David was facing.
现在我们一起来看一看大卫到底面对什么样的困难。
First, we start with what did David think in his heart.
第一个，大卫到底心里对自己说什么？
He said to himself something.
他告诉自己。
Let's turn to 1 Samuel chapter 27 verse 1.
我们一起翻到撒母耳记上27章第一节。
1 Samuel 27 verse 1.
撒母耳记二十七章第一节，大卫心里说：“必有一日，我死在扫罗的手里，不如逃奔非利士地去。扫罗见我不在以色列的境内，就必绝望，不再寻索我。这样，我可以脱离他的手。”
The background of the story is Saul pursued David's life.
在这样的情况下，背景是扫罗在追杀大卫。
Last week we studied about David and Goliath.
上个礼拜我们学习了大卫与歌利亚。
David slaughtered the giant Goliath.
大卫杀了巨人歌利亚。
Everybody is praising him.
大家都称赞他。
The king Saul jealous against him.
不过这时候扫罗是心里非常嫉妒的。
The devils occupy Saul, and Saul want to kill David.
这时候恶魔就进入了扫罗的心，扫罗就想要追杀大卫。
And then David has to run for his life.
所以这时候大卫就要逃命了。
But even though God protect David many, many times.
不过即使尽管神保护了大卫非常多次。
But David in his heart, he didn't feel very secure.
可是在大卫的心里还是觉得没有安全感。
So he tell himself in his heart.
所以他心里就这样告诉自己。
We all talk to ourselves sometimes, right? Every day.
有时候我们常常在心里对自己说话。
A lot of conversation going on in your brain.
可能在你的脑里有很多的对话。
Okay, now what did David tell himself?
好的，现在来看大卫到底告诉自己什么。
He said, now I should perish someday by the hand of Saul.
他说，必有一日我死在扫罗的手里。
Because if things keep going on like this,
如果每天我都这样过下去，
you know, I'm so close to death every single day.
我每天都离死不过一步啊。
No, Saul will ever kill me.
终有一日，扫罗会解决我的。
So David think to himself, what should I do now?
所以大卫就告诉自己，我该怎么办呢？
There's an idea came. They wanted to go and flee to the land of the Philistines.
这时候他脑袋里面就出现了一个画面，不如我逃奔到非利士好了。
Because Philistine is another country where King Saul didn't have control.
因为非利士地是另外一个国家，扫罗王在那里没有权利。
So if he knew me, I'm there, then he'll give up looking after me, looking.For me.
如果他知道我不在犹大地里面，那他就不会再寻索我。
This is an idea pop up in his mind.
这是在他头脑里面跳出来的一个点子。
But did he pray about this idea? Did he ask God about the idea?
不过他有求问神吗？
No, the Bible didn't say anything. He prayed to God and asked for this direction.
不过在圣经里并没有记载他用这个点子来向神祷告。
Let's turn to Proverbs 16 verse 9.
我们来看箴言十六章第九节。
Proverbs 16 verse 9.
箴言十六章第九节。
16 verse 9 says, A man's heart plan his way, but the Lord direct his steps.
这里讲到人心筹算自己的道路，为耶和华指引他的脚步。
Yeah, we can do our planning.
是的，我们可以自己做计划。
But actually, the outcome is not up to you.
不过未来不在你手上。
Actually, the Lord is directing your steps.
只有神能够指引人的脚步。
So that's to remind us, yeah, we can do planning, but you better include God into the equation.
是的，这里就教导我们，我们可以计划自己的道路，可是我们应该把神包含进来。
You can bring your plan to God and ask Him whether you approve it.It's not up to me, but it's up to you.
你可以把自己的计划摆到神面前，问他说：“这样好吗？”
However, David didn't ask God about this idea.
不过是大卫并没有求问神。
And he made up his mind.
而且他在心里已经决定了。
Now, before we continue, actually, it's very interesting.
在我们继续下去的时候，有一件很有趣的事。
It is not the first time that David wanted to go to the land of Philistine.
其实，在大卫之前他已经就想去腓力士地。
Actually, he went there once already.
他已经去过一次了。
It didn't end up well.
那次的下场也没有很好。
Let's turn back to chapter 21.
我们翻回来撒母耳记上第二十一章。
Chapter 21.
第二十一章。
Verse 10 to 11.
第十节到第十一节。
Verse 10 to 11.
第十节，那日大卫起来躲避扫罗，逃到加特王雅吉那里。
11.
雅吉的臣仆对雅吉说：“这不是以色列国王大卫吗？那里的妇女跳舞唱和，不是指着他说，扫罗杀死千千，大卫杀死万万吗？”
Look at here, just not long ago, David went there already.
其实，在不久之前，大卫已经去过腓力士地了。
In his heart, he thinks that Philistine, the Achish, can protect him.
他心里想说，可能加特王雅吉可以保护他。
But when we went there, the officer, the other people around the king said to the king, Hey, isn't that guy the one who killed Goliath?
不过在那一天，雅吉的臣仆就告诉他们的国王说，这不是以色列的那位大卫杀死哥利亚那个吗？
Wow, he slain tens of thousands.
而且妇女还指着他说，他杀死了万万。
Oh, when David heard about this, he, wow.I'm known here, I'm famous here for killing Goliath, killing Philistine.
他在听到人这样说之后，他就明白了，原来他在加特那个地方还是有名声的，大家都知道他杀了哥利亚。
Can you imagine? You go to Philistine after you kill the number one warrior of Philistine. What will happen to you?
你可以想一想，当你去到腓力士地，然后他们又知道你就是杀死他们第一战士的人。
David regretted. He think I make a mistake coming here.
大卫马上就后悔了。
So David is a good actor. Immediately he act like a crazy man every day.
这时候大卫就开始装疯卖傻。
Ah, so look at the next map. You know the location. Where is Philistine on the left corner? Where the arrow is pointing you, right?
我们看地图就知道，腓力士地是在犹大地的左边。
So that Gath, G-A-T-H, is the small city, but the king is called Achish.
那个加特是一个小城市，那个有一个王叫做雅吉。
So David ran away from Judah and go to Gath.
所以这时候大卫是从犹大跑到加特这个地。
But he didn't feel safe.
可是他还是觉得不安。
Let's read verse 12 to 15.
我们再读十二到十五节。
Let's turn back to chapter 21, verse 12 to 15.
我们翻回来二十一章十二到十五节。大卫将这话放在心里，甚惧怕加特王雅吉。
13.
就在众人面前改变了寻常的举动，在他们手下假装疯癫，在城门的门扇上胡写乱画，使唾沫留在胡子上。
14.
雅吉对臣仆说：“你们看，这人是疯子，为什么带他到我这里来呢？
15.
我岂缺少疯子？你们带这人来，在我面前疯癫吗？这人岂可进我的家呢？”
Look at David. After he arrived in the land of Philistine, he didn't feel secure.
我们看看大卫来到腓力士地，他心里还是觉得很害怕。
He wants Achish to protect him, but he's afraid of him.
他其实本来的原意是想要雅吉来保护他。
But now he's afraid.
可是他这时候非常惧怕。
So he tried to think about a way to protect himself.
所以他就改变了寻常的举动来保护自己。
Pretend to be a madman, somebody off his mind.
他就假装疯癫
saying bad things, and then there's saliva going through his mouth and beer every day.
他就使唾沫留在胡子上，然后乱说一些话。
Just like those being locked up in the mental hospital.
就很像马上要被抓进精神病院的人一样。
So people say, why you? And then the king said, why do you bring me a crazy man?
那雅吉就对臣仆说，为什么带这个疯子到我这里来呢？
So they let David go.
所以他们就让大卫离开了。
So David was there before.
所以其实大卫已经去过非利士地。
Not long ago.
在不久之前。
And after that, God tell David, you know, don't go anywhere, just stay in Judah.
在那之后，神的旨意已经告诉大卫是要他留在犹大。
Let's turn to chapter 22, verse 3.
我们来看二十二章的第三节。
Chapter 22, verse 3.
第二十二章的第三节。大卫从那里往摩押的米斯巴去，对摩押王说：“求你容我父母搬来住在你们这里，等我知道神要为我怎样行。”
Verse 4.
大卫领他父母到摩押王面前，大卫住山寨多少日子，他父母也住摩押王那里多少日子。
Verse 5.
先知加德对大卫说：“你不要住在山寨，要往犹大地去。”大卫就离开那里，进入哈列的树林。
Now we are just like David, when we are facing difficult situation, we use our brain and try to find out many different ways.
我们就像大卫一样，当我们遇到困难的时候，我们就在脑子里面不断的盘算应该怎样做才好。
Because David is a smart person. He knows there's many ways he can do things.
因为大卫他是个聪明人，他在心里是有想法的。
Oh, if going to Philistine doesn't work, maybe I can try go to Moab, another foreign country.
那如果说留在非利士地这样是不行的话，那要不然就去另外一个国家摩押好了。
And the king of Moab let him stay there.
那摩押王就让他住在那里。
It seems that he is pretty comfortable, pretty secure.
而且在那里好像也过得不错。
But you know, God told David through the prophet.
不过神借着先知告诉大卫
，Don't stay there.
不要待在那里。
Don't stay in the stronghold.
不要住在山寨。
Don't hide yourself in the stronghold.
不要躲在山寨里。
Go back to Judah.
要往回去犹大地。
This looked like a suicide, right? This looked like a crazy idea.
这就像一个疯狂的计划一样，要他回去自杀一样。
God sometimes give you a crazy idea. You think God is not giving you good idea.
神有时候给你的计划听起来是很疯狂的。
I'm staying in Moab. I'm very safe. And now you tell me to go to Judah, where King Saul can look at me and then try to kill me.
我待在这里是很安全的。你为什么要叫我回犹大地？这样扫罗就很容易找到我。
But God has a plan.
不过神有他的计划。
Without I allowing, nobody can harm you. Even though you're in Judah, nobody can harm you.
只要我不允许，没有任何人可以伤害你。
You'll be the king, and you'll be the king of Judah first.
而且你以后会当王，第一会先当犹大的王。
If you don't stay in Judah, how can I make you king?
如果你不待在犹大地，我怎么让你当犹大王呢
？You hide in the mountain there. How can I make you king?
你躲在山上的山寨里，我怎么让你当王呢
？God has a higher plan.
神有更高的指示。
But when we don't understand God's will, we think God is making a mistake. God doesn't make sense.
不过当我们还不明白神的意思的时候，我们就觉得神做错了。
So, of course, we cannot blame David. If we are him, we'll make the same mistake.
当然我们不能责怪大卫，因为如果我们是他，我们也会做一样的决定。
Because he's afraid of his life.
因为他正在逃命啊。
Today, we look at the news, right? These few days, the news talking about Ukraine.
我们看到新闻都知道这几天的乌克兰。
Wow, the people are suffering there.
那边的人民已经开始受苦了。
Russia, the tank, the missile, the attack, the soldier are going there, killing people every day.
俄罗斯的军队已经进攻乌克兰了。
Of course, people want to run for their life. They're so afraid.
当然，人民是非常害怕的，在逃命。
So we really have to pray for the people there.
所以我们应该要为乌克兰的人民祷告。
So David, he was being pursued. He's no security.
所以当大卫逃命的时候，心里是非常没有安全感。
So don't blame him. We'll make the same mistake if we were him.
所以当然我们不可以责怪他，因为我们要是他也会犯一样的错。
So now going back to chapter 27, he wants to go to Philistine again.
好，所以现在我们翻回二十七章，我们看到大卫又想要回去非利士地了。
Yeah, he tried to make the same mistake.
他又要犯一样的错了。
Let's turn back to chapter 27, verse 2 to 3.
我们翻到二十七章的第二到第三节。
Chapter 27, verse 2 to 3.
二十七章第二节，于是大卫起身和跟随他的六百人投奔加特王马厄的儿子雅吉去了。
Verse 3.
大卫和他的两个妻，就是耶斯列人雅西暖和做过拿巴妻的加密人雅比该，并跟随他的人，连个人的眷属都住在加特的雅吉那里。
Now the second time David entered under the protection of Gad, the king, Achish, the king of Gad.
所以这个地方，大卫第二次寻求加特王雅吉的保护。
Now, this time he come with a lot of people, 600 of his followers, 600 soldiers.
这时候，他和跟随他的六百人一起来投奔雅吉。
His family and everyone of the family of the soldier.
就是他的家人，还有所有 跟随他的人的家人。
Now he used his own mind to think about this method. Yes, and now I must go to Philistine.
这是他自己想出来的办法，就是说我必须去到加特。
But look at this. What is the problem of this?
不过这到底有什么问题呢？
From this moment, David tried to contradict himself.
这个时候
next line.
这个时候大卫非常的矛盾。
Next line already.Just last week, we studied about David hate Philistine, hate Goliath, hate the people who curse God.
就像上个礼拜我们学习的，大卫讨厌非利士人，讨厌哥利亚，讨厌那些咒骂神军队的人。
But now he's going back to the people who he hated the most and try to seek protection.
不过现在他想要依靠他最讨厌的敌人来保护自己。
Yeah, sometimes when you are afraid, you make not a very good decision.
有时候当我们害怕的时候，头脑不清楚。
Sometimes you are under stress.You make decisions that contradict your value.
有时候我们在极大的压力之下，我们会做一些决定来矛盾我们自己的原则。
Sometimes you want just simply want to survive. You can forget who you are and what you hate.
有时候我们为了要生存下去，我们甚至已经忘记自己的原则。
Yeah, this is because the stress and the pressure.
这是因为极大的压力。
So David, he tried to ask the people he hated to protect him.
所以这里大卫他想要依靠他最讨厌的人来保护他。
So, sometimes we may make the same mistake.
有时候我们也是会这样做。
We are under financial stress and try to get money. Sometimes we forget our value.
有时候我们因为遇到经济危机，所以我们心里非常想得到钱财，我们就会违背自己的原则。
Sometimes we want an advancement in our career.
有时候我们想要投资自己的事业。
But sometimes we go against our own thinking, our own value.
可是有时候要违背自己的价值观。
Sometimes we go against our honesty.
有时候甚至要违背自己的诚实。
This is our weakness.
这是我们的弱点。
Now David, now he is very weak.
现在大卫非常的软弱。
Now he didn't ask God before he made this decision.
在他做这样的计划之前，他并没有求问神。
The problem and the result is he put himself into a dilemma, into a very difficult situation.
就这样，他把自己放在一个更困难的境地里。
We are on slide 13 already. He didn't seek the law. Now he is in a dilemma.
他并没有求问神，就把自己陷入两难的境地。
Now, brother, sister, let's stop here. Think about ourselves. Are we like David sometime?
弟兄姐妹，我们要停下来想一想，我们是不是跟大卫很像呢？
Whenever we start to lose trust in God,
当你失去对神信靠的心，
when we don't think that God really can protect us.
当我们觉得神应该没办法保护我们，
we started to have a lot losing the sense of security.
我们就失去安全感。
When you don't have security in your heart,
当你心里没有安全感的时候，
you try to make different decisions, back and forth. Should I do this or do that? Should I do this or do that?
我们就会反复无定的来做这些左右摇摆的决定。
Right, just like David, he went there, he left, and then now he go there again.
就像大卫，他去了加特，离开了，又去。
And then now he decided he go there again.
当他现在决定要再去的时候，
But actually he put himself into a deeper trouble.
他把自己放入更深的困难里。
If you don't ask God, if you don't rely on God, you try to solve problem, but you make yourself more problem.
当你没有求问神，你只是自己想办法，你就会把自己放入更困难的境地。
Now let's see how the story goes. How David put himself into more trouble.
好，我们现在来看大卫是如何把自己放在两难中。
Now, secondly, now we see what David said to King of Gad.
第二点，我们要来看大卫嘴里说什么。
Let's read chapter 27, verse 8 to 9.
我们来看第二十七章的第八还有第九节。
First chapter 27, First Samuel 27, verse 8 to 9.
撒母耳记上二十七章第八节，大卫和跟随他的人上去，侵夺基述人、基色人、亚玛利人之地。这几族历来住在那里，从舒尔直到埃及。大卫击杀那地的人，无论男女都没有留下一个，又夺获牛羊骆驼驴并衣服回来见雅吉。
Okay, now King David, I'm not yet king yet, right? David, what did he do all this time when he was living in Philistine?
这里我们看一看，他住在非利士地的时候，他做了什么？
He go to attack a lot of foreign places.
他去攻击很多。
Including the Gizites, Amalekites, and those countries.
他去攻击那些外国人，是住在基述、基色，还有亚玛利。
And plunder, and then get everything.
还有掳掠了那地全部的东西。
And then come to Achish.
再回来见雅吉。
Oh, Achish is very happy because he bring a lot of material.
那亚吉看到就非常开心，因为他带了很多战利品回来。
Verse ten.
第十节。
Verse ten.
亚吉说：“你们今日侵夺了什么地方呢？”大卫说：“侵夺了犹大的南方、耶拉灭的南方、基尼的南方。”
Verse 11.
无论男女，大卫没有留下一个带到加特来。他说：“恐怕他们将我们的事告诉人，说大卫住在非利士地的时候，常常这样行。”
Look at David. He started to change.
我们来看看大卫改变了。
He started to lie.
他开始说谎。
You know, King Achish asked him, "Where have you been? Where do you get all this cattle, all these things?"
亚吉问他：“你们今天侵略了什么地方？”
David said, "Oh, I attacked Judah. I attacked your enemy, right? I attacked my own people, and then get all this thing here for you."
大卫说：“我侵夺了犹大的南方，我侵夺了你的敌人，就是我的同胞。”
Is it true?
是对的吗？
No, he didn't. He didn't attack Judah.
并不是这样的。
He attacked the Gentiles. He attacked Amalekites.
他是侵夺亚玛利人之地。
But he wanted to gain the trust. He wanted to gain the trust of the king.
可是他并没有对亚吉说实话。
He wanted to gain the trust.
他想要得到亚吉的信任。
I'm not helping my people anymore. I plunder them. I attack them.
我再也不认同我的同胞。我今天是侵夺了犹大的南地。
So he lied to Achish.
所以他对亚吉说谎了。
He wanted to gain his trust.
他想要得到他的信任。
But at the same time, he knows he belongs to Judah. How can he help? How can he attack Judah?
在他心里，他明白他自己就是犹大人，他怎么能侵夺犹大呢？
But he already in a very delicate situation.
不过他已经来到一个不可逆转的点了。
He need to survive.
他需要生存下去。
So he need to please Achish.
所以他要取悦亚吉。
But in his heart, he belongs to Israel.
可是他的心是属于犹大的。
Next line tells us David started to live a double life.
所以下一张图就是大卫开始了他的双面人生活。
It is not easy to live a double side man.
说实在，当一个双面人并不容易。
Well, in order to survive, you know, sometimes you have to put on a mask, right?
为了要生存下去，有时候不得不戴上假面具。
Because you put yourself into this situation，
因为你把自己放在这样的境地里。
You think you are smart, you want to go to the Philistine or Philistine, then you have to act, you have to make up something。
因为当你想要生存，那你又住在非利士地，你不得不说这些谎。
Now, brother and sister, are we doing this a lot of time？
弟兄姐妹，我们是不是有这样的经验呢
？Yeah, we want to please God。
是的，我们想要得神喜悦。
But sometimes we think that life is difficult. If I cannot just rely on God, I have to do something.
不过有时候我们心里又想，生活这么艰难，我不可以只是依靠神，我还要自己想一点办法。
I have to be true. I have to be smart. I have to please the people, please the world too.
我要自己想办法来取悦身边的人。
Sometimes we have just like David at that time, we have a double face, double personality.
就像大卫一样，我们有时候过的就是双面人的生活。
Come to church, we have one face.
来到教会，我们就像个基督徒。
Oh, hallelujah, praise the Lord, do holy work.
哈利路亚，感谢神，我们很努力做圣工。
But going outside, we want to please the world, tell the world that, yeah, we are together, I belong here, you belong to me.
不过去到外面，我们又想要跟这个世界为伍，当他们的好朋友。
Is it true? Is it what we are trying to do?
这是我们今天做的事吗？
You want to please both sides?
你想要取悦两边的人吗？
David, at that time, he really wanted to please both sides.
大卫那时候的确是想要两面都讨好。
Now, when you rely on yourself, you try to solve your problem, maybe your solution seems to work at the beginning.
看起来在表面上是非常的美好，好像解决了很多事情。
All right, next line says, yeah, David has protection.
是的，他得到了保护。
King Achish protect him.
亚吉王保护他。
And then he pleased the king of Philistine, he gained his trust.
然后他还得到加特王亚吉的信任。
And then Saul has no way to harm him.
而且扫罗也碰不着他。
At the same time, he earned a lot of money, a lot of cattle, a lot of sheep. He's materially, he's having an abundance.
同时，他又得到了很多牛羊驴。
And then also, he's winning all his battles. He go everywhere, he's winning.
而且他不管打哪一场仗，他都是成功，都是胜利的。
On the surface, everything is working well.
表面上看起来一切都很美好。
Now, sometimes when you rely on yourself.You think about your own way. Yeah, things may seem to be working at the beginning.
是的，有时候我们自己想办法，靠着我们的力量，一切看起来都还不错。
But don't be happy. This is only on surface, 表象而已。
不过不要高兴得太早，这都是一切的表象而已。
Problem will come back to you if you don't rely on God.
问题马上就来了，如果你不依赖神。
Now, what is the problem?
那我们现在来看看到底什么是这个问题。
Let's turn to chapter 28, verse 1 to 2.
我们来看看28章的第一、第二节。
Chapter 28, verse 1 to 2.
28章第一节。那时非利士人聚集军旅，要与以色列人打仗。亚吉对大卫说：你当知道，你和跟随你的人都要随我出战。
Verse 2.
大卫对亚吉说：仆人所能做的事，王必知道。亚吉对大卫说：这样，我立你永远做我的护卫长。
Now, King Achish told David, now we're going to have a military campaign, and we are going to fight Israel.
现在亚吉告诉大卫说，我们要聚集军旅，要与以色列人打仗。
Because we know Israel and Philistine, they are our enemies.
我们知道非利士人跟以色列人一直都是敌人。
Now Achish observed David all this while. He seems to be quite loyal to me, and he deserted his country.
亚吉在这一阵子观察大卫，发现大卫对他非常的忠心，所以他很信任他。
Because David told me he attacked his own country.
因为大卫已经告诉我他攻击他自己的国家。
So Achish want to invite David, test his loyalty. Let's go to fight Israel together.
所以亚吉告诉大卫一起来打仗，其实也是要测试他的忠诚度。
Now, if you are David, what do you think now? Can you say no?
如果你是大卫，现在你能说不吗？
You are just like a spy, right? You are just like a spy from Israel, and then try to hide there. And then if you expose your true identity, what will happen to you?
你就像一个以色列的间谍，你现在来到加特王这边，如果你暴露身份，会是什么样的下场？
He's just like an undercover agent.
他就像一个间谍一样。
Now, what can David say?
现在大卫能说什么？
He have to keep acting.
他就继续装下去。
He have to keep. He's not. There's nothing. He cannot tell the truth.
他不能说实话。
Well, he tried to be. You know, look at verse 2. Surely you know what your servant can do.
第二节，他对亚吉说：“仆人所能做的事，王必知道。”
You know what I can do, right? You can say. You can tell me. You can say what I can do.
大卫说：“你知道我能做什么，请你告诉我。”
Wow. And then verse 2. The king Achish immediately promoted him to become, you know, my chief guardians.
这时候亚吉对大卫说，我帮你升官，你永远做我的护卫长。
Now, is David happy or not?
这时候大卫开心吗？
I think he's very unhappy. He's very struggling.
我想他心里应该充满挣扎吧。
Now he's about to go to battle.
现在他要出去打仗了。
To fight his own country.
可是对象是自己的人民。
But there's no way he can get away from it.
可是他又没有办法抽身。
In his heart, you know, he relied on himself. He put himself into this kind of situation.
他心里明白是我自己把自己放到这样的境地的。
But thank God, God loved David.
不过感谢神，神非常爱大卫。
God made the other Philistine ruler oppose the idea of having David to go together.
啊，神让亚吉的臣仆对亚吉说，大卫不可以跟我们一起去打仗。
This guy, if he go there, he will go back and then go against us.
如果这个人上战场，结果在战场上突然倒过来攻击我们，那我们怎么办呢？
This is.From the hand of God.
这是神出手了。
God really wants David to save him from this trouble.
神想要救大卫离开这样的境地。
But David didn't know.
不过大卫还不明白。
David keep acting, keep just like acting as nothing happened.
大卫选择继续当他的双面人。
Let's read chapter 29, verse 8.
我们来看第29章第八节。
Chapter 29, verse 8.
第二十九章第八节，大卫对亚吉说：“我做了什么呢？自从仆人到你面前，直到今日，你查出我有什么过错，使我不去攻击主我王的仇敌呢？”
You know, after King Philistine told David this news, you cannot go.
当亚吉告诉大卫说你不能去的时候、
right. ，If you are David, what can you do?
如果你是大卫，你会说什么
？If you are very happy, oh yeah, don't have to go. Thank God, and then you know you are spy. You are not good.
如果大卫当着亚吉的面说：“哦，太好了，我不用去打仗了。”
You have to keep acting. Oh, why don't you let me go? Did I do anything wrong?
所以这时候大卫不能暴露自己的身份，他就说：“我做了什么？你为什么不让我去呢？”
Because he want to keep staying there.
因为他要一直待在那里。
Now until this point, David keep relying on himself.
所以直到这一天，大卫都还是依赖他自己的能力。
Verse 11, chapter 29, verse 11.
第二十九章十一节。于是大卫和跟随他的人早晨起来，回往非利士地去。非利士人也上耶斯列去了。
Okay, David went back to his base in the land of Philistine.
这时候大卫就跟他跟随他的人早上起来回家了。
Now, seems David using his smart acting, his back and forth, and then he is surviving between these two countries.
目前看起来好像大卫是用自己的智慧来生存下来。
But now God wants to force him to make a change.
不过神在这时候逼他要做个改变。
God have to act.
神要行动了。
Sometimes you don't want to force God to act, right?
有时候我们不要逼神出手。
But if you don't change, you keep doing your own way, God have to act.
如果我们自己没有做对的决定，我们就是逼神出手。
Now God have to act.
这时候神就出手了。
Because let's think about the next line. Think about, are you living a double life?
我们来自己想一想，我们有没有做双面人呢？
When you face difficulty, do you rely on yourself or you trust God?
当我们面对困难的时候，我们是选择靠自己还是靠神呢？
If God still loves you, He will force you to change.
如果神还爱你，他就会逼你改变。
And now God have to act. How can God help David to change?
现在神就出手了，那他是如何帮助大卫来改变的呢？
Let's read chapter 30, verse 1 to 4.
我们来看第三十章第一到第四节。
Chapter 30, verse 1 to 4.
第三十章第一节。第三日，大卫和跟随他的人到了喜格拉，亚玛利人已经侵夺南地，攻破喜格拉，用火焚烧，掳了城内的妇女和其中的大小人口，却没有杀一个，都带着走了。大卫和跟随他的人就到了那城，不料城已烧毁，他们的妻子儿女都被掳去了。大卫和跟随他的人就放声大哭，直哭得没有力气。
Now God started to work.
这时候神动手了。
God led him to face an unprecedented crisis.
这时候神让他面对人生从未遇过的大危机。
Even Goliath is nothing compared to this.
就算哥利亚都比不上这个危机。
Now David has two wives. David has a lot of children.
这时候大卫已经有两个妻子，还有很多孩子。
And all his soldiers have children and wife.
他的军人里面也有自己的家庭。
Now when they go back to their base, they find out that everything is gone.
可是当他们回到自己的家的时候，他们发现什么都不见了。
And the city was burned.
城已被烧毁。
You don't even know whether they are alive or dead.
他们都不知道自己的妻子儿女是死是活。
Can you imagine one day you go from your office, go home, find out that your house is burned, you don't see your family?
你可以想象，当你有一天你下班回到家，发现你的家已经烧毁，而且家人都不见了。
You don't even know whether they're dead or alive.
你不知道他们是死是活。
How would you feel?
那你会感觉如何？
So that is a crisis.
那就是很大的危机。
God loved David and let him face this crisis.
神因为很爱大卫，所以让他面对这样的危机。
All his family are gone, are plundered, they are being captured.
他的妻子儿女都被掳走了。
But a crisis is a turning point and an opportunity for the faith to grow, to change.
不过危机就是转机，神用这个点让我们可以继续转回来面向他。
Now David is going to make a prayer that's going to change his fate, change his future.
这时候大卫就做了一个改变命运的祷告。
Let's read verse 6, chapter 30, verse 6.
我们来看第三十章第六节。大卫甚是焦急，因众人为自己的儿女苦恼，说要用石头打死他。大卫却依靠耶和华他的神，心里坚固。
Look at this, what David was facing.
这里我们看看大卫还要面对怎么样的危机。
He himself is very sad, very sorrowful, very troubled.
他已经非常的着急了。
But now his followers turn against him and want to stone him to death because you are the one who harm our family, they said.
因为这些跟随他的人为自己的儿女苦恼，并且说要用石头打死他。
They're out of their mind already.
因为他们已经疯狂了，觉得这一切的过错都是大卫要负责的。
Now David is facing an unprecedented crisis.
大卫在这里面对前所未有的危机。
But what can he do?
可是他能做什么呢？
Suddenly he knows his diplomacy or acting doesn't work anymore.
这时候他突然明白了自己的计谋还有自己的假装都救不了他。
His eloquent tongue doesn't help him anymore.
他那么有口才也是救不了自己。
His planning, his organization doesn't help him anymore.
他的计划也再也帮不了自己。
Nothing that he is proud of can save him from this trouble.
他所骄傲的一切才能在这个时刻都救不了他。
But suddenly he thinks about, yes, I still have God.
突然间他明白我还有神。
I still have God, even though I lose everything.
虽然我已经失去一切，可是神还在我这边。
Even though I don't know what to do next, but I still have God.
就算我不知道下一步要怎么走，可是我还有神。
You know, brother and sister, sometimes God has to take away the things that you are proud of to let you know that you are nothing, but you can only rely on God.
弟兄姐妹，有时候神要把我们所爱的、所拥有的一切拿走， 我们才知道我们还有神。
Let's turn to Psalm chapter 56.
我们 来读诗篇五十六篇第三节。
Psalm chapter 56 verse 3.
我们来看诗篇五十六篇第三节，我惧怕的时候要依靠你。
Yes, whenever I am afraid, I will trust in you.
是的，当我惧怕的时候我要依靠你。
When did David wrote this hymn?
这是什么时候大卫写的诗呢？
Here mentioned about David and when the Philistine and Gad, he wrote his hymn.
这里上面有小字提到非利士人在加特拿住大卫，那时他作这道经诗。
Probably he was facing some trouble there at that time.
也有可能他那时候也面对了困难。
The Bible didn't really explain, didn't record why David was arrested in Gath.
这里圣经并没有告诉我们为什么非利士人那时候拿住大卫。
But it seems that something happened.
不过看起来有发生什么事。
But anyway, David said, "Whenever I'm afraid, I will trust in you."
不过不管如何，大卫说，我惧怕的时候要依靠你。
Brother and sister, when you read the news, watch the video when the people in Ukraine, you know, they were hiding under the underground, the metro, they're so afraid.
我们看到在新闻上，乌克兰的居民他们。很害怕要逃难，有些人甚至躲到了地铁的下面。
Wow, a lot of children, they are still mothers still holding them.
还有很多孩子是被父母抱着的。
Young mother, they're crying.
年轻的妈妈在街边哭。
The husband have to go to the battlefield and say goodbye to the daughter and crying.
丈夫必须要上战场，所以跟家人泪别。
Yeah, because when you don't have anyone to trust, you can only cry, you can only be afraid.
因为当你没有任何人可以依靠的时候，你只能害怕，只能哭。
Because you don't know whether tomorrow you are dead or alive.
因为你并不知道明天你是活还是死。
Well, don't think that is very far, far, far away. Maybe something we have to face the similar situation.
我们不要觉得那件事离开我们非常遥远，可能有一天我们也会遇到。
This is the end time.
因为这是末世。
War, troubles everywhere in the world. One day.
战争、患难随处可见。
Persecution.
或者是逼迫。
We don't know when it will happen to us.
我们不知道什么时候会临到我们。
But we know one thing.
可是我们知道一件事。
We are not like those who doesn't have any help.
我们并不是那些无助的人。
We have God.
我们有神。
If ever one day you are in a very dire situation, very troublesome situation.
如果有一天我们必须面对这样的境况。
When you feel like running away.
如果你很想逃命的时候。
Where can you run?
你可以跑到哪里去呢？
Just like people, they're hiding underground. Besides underground, where can they go?
就像那些人民，他们躲在地底下。除了这些地方，他们能去哪里？
David, where can he go now?
大卫这时候能去哪里？
Suddenly he remembered, I have to run to God.
突然间，他醒悟过来，我要奔向神。
Now he made the prayer that changes life.
这时候他就做了一个改变命运的祷告。
Immediately he asked the priest.
突然之间，他就跟他的祭司说。
And then he started to pray to God.
他就开始向神祷告。
Let's turn to First Samuel chapter 30 verse 8.
我们来读回撒母耳记上三十章第八节。
Chapter 30 verse 7 to 8. Verse 7 to 8.
我们来看第七还有第八节。大卫对亚希米勒的儿子祭司亚比亚他说：“请你将以弗德拿过来。”亚比亚他就将以弗德拿到大卫面前。
Verse 8.
大卫求问耶和华说：“我追赶敌军，追得上，追不上呢？”耶和华说：“你可以追，必追得上，都救得回来。”
Suddenly, David remembered, "Yeah, I have not prayed to God for a long time."
这时候，大卫突然发现自己对神很久没有祷告了。
The last time we heard him praying, asking for God, is chapter 23.
在上一次记载他祷告的时候，是记在二十三章的地方。
But since then, he hasn't asked God about many things.
从那时候开始，大卫就忘记向神祷告了。
He using his own mind to make decision.
他用自己的想法来做决定。
But now he say, "Okay, bring the ephod. Let me inquire of the Lord."
现在他对祭司说：“把以弗德拿过来。”他就向神求问。
He ask God, "If we going to go against the enemy, can we pursue the troop?" God said, "Yes."
他求问神说：“我追赶敌军能追得上吗
？”Will we be successful? God said, "Yes."
我会成功把人救回来吗？神说是的。
Sometimes God is just waiting for us to humble ourselves.
有时候神就是在等我们谦卑下来。
Don't rely on yourself anymore.
不要依靠自己。
Don't think you are smart.
不要觉得自己很聪明。
Don't think you can say this and that, you can solve the problem.
不要觉得自己可以解决这个，解决那个。
Sometimes we think we are smart, but we make ourselves even more problem.
有时候我们觉得自己很聪明，其实是把自己陷入更大的麻烦。
Sometimes something so simple, but because we are proud, we don't rely on God enough, and then we are put yourself into more trouble.
有时候一件简单的事，因为我们自己觉得自己能够做好。
But whenever you're willing to come before the Lord,
可是当你来到神面前
，God, I don't know anything.
神啊，我不知道要怎么做。
But you, do you want me to do this?
你要我这样做吗
？Will you give me success if I rely on you?
如果我依靠你，你会给我成功吗
？This is what God is waiting.
这是神在等待我们的。
You don't have to be smart in front of God.
你不需要在神面前表现得非常聪明。
You just have to be humble.
你只需要谦卑。
When your heart is humble, God opens a way.
当你心里谦卑下来，神就开了一条出路。
Let's read chapter 17 and verse 18.
我们来读第十七、十八节。
Chapter 30, verse 17 to 18.
第三十章十七、十八节。大卫从黎明直到次日晚上击杀他们，除了四百骑骆驼的少年人之外，没有一个逃脱的。
Verse 18.
亚玛利人所掳去的财物，大卫全都夺回，并救回他的两个妻来。
You see how God helping David again?
我们在这里看见神如何帮助大卫。
Yes, David.Rescue all his wife and his soldier's wife and all the children and all the possession.
我们在这里看见大卫夺回所有他们的财物，还有他的家人。
Not even one person is lost.
没有一个失去的。
It's a miracle.
这是一个神迹。
Because God allowed this test to happen to David.
因为神容许这个测试在大卫身上发生。
Sometimes God allows bad things happen to you, bad luck happen to you. He wants to test you. He wants to push you, force you to change.
有时候神好像让坏运发生在我们身上，其实是要逼我们改变。
Whether personally in our life,
不管是我们个人的生活
or family,
或是我们的家庭
or even holy work,
或者是圣工上的。
When we see there's so many things not working well, you have to think what went wrong.
我们在看见很多事情不顺利的时候，我们就会想到底是搞怎么了呢？
Don't just pray to God, oh, make it solve the problem, solve the problem.
我们不要只是祷告神说求神解决这个问题。
God allow this to happen is to force you to change.
神让这件事情发生就是要逼我们改变。
We have to be humble before God.
我们要在神面前谦卑。
What is my problem?
我的问题是什么呢
？What is our problem?
我们的问题是什么
？If we truly humble ourselves, God will show us the way.
如果我们真正谦卑下来，神就会给我们开一条出路。
Now the story didn't end here.
那故事并没有在这里结束。
But the last line tell you if it were not for God's protection, what would have happened?
最后一张图告诉我们说
slide 27,
若不是神的保守，大卫差一点就变成怎么样的人呢？
He almost became the enemy of Israel.
他差一点变成他祖国的敌人。
If he was allowed to fight that battle, what would happen?
如果亚基王真的带领他上那个战场，那会发生什么事？
Let's read chapter 31, verse 1 to 2.
我们来看三十一章第一还有第二节。
Chapter 31, verse 1 to 2.
三十一章第一节，非利士人与以色列人征战，以色列人在非利士人面前逃跑，在基利波有被杀扑倒的。
Verse 2.
非利士人紧追扫罗和他儿子们，就杀了扫罗的儿子约拿丹、亚比拿达、麦基舒亚。
You know what happened? If David had gone to the battlefield on that day,
你知道如果那天大卫真的上了这场战场，
Who will he face?
他会面对谁？
He will face his best friend, Jonathan.
他会面对自己最好的朋友约拿丹。
Maybe they have to fight each other.
可能他们要对打。
He may get killed, or he may have to kill Jonathan.
他可能会被杀，或者是他杀了约拿丹。
He may have to kill King Saul.
或者是他杀了扫罗。
Even if kill one Judah, one Israel soldier, his whole life, his conscience will not be clear.
就算他杀了一个无名的犹大军人，他一辈子都没有办法心安。
And he will never be king.
而且他永远不可能成为犹大王。
If on that day he went to the battlefield.
如果他那一天真的上了战场。
But thank God, God protected him.
不过感谢神，神保护了他。
But who put himself into that trouble?
不过到底是谁把他放到这样的困难里呢？
He put himself into that spot.
是他自己把自己放进去的。
God delivered him.
神带领他出来。
But God have to teach him a lesson.
不过神教导他很重要的一课。
Now, brother and sister, after listening the story, what have you learned tonight?
所以弟兄姐妹，今晚我们听了这些故事之后，我们学到了什么呢？
The conclusion that I have, after learning all this, maybe you have a different conclusion.
当我自己学习了这一段之后，我的结论是。
The conclusion is.
结论是。
We have to put down our pride.
我们要放下自己的骄傲。
Don't ever rely on yourself anymore.
不要再靠自己了。
Don't think you are smart.
不要觉得自己很聪明。
Don't think you have experience.
不要觉得你很有经验。
Don't think I can solve this problem.
不要觉得自己可以解决很多问题。
Big or small, we have to just be humble and ask God to give us guidance.
或大或小的问题，我们都要求神来帮助带领我们。
And prayer can change everything.
还有祷告可以改变一切事。
Prayer can change everything.
祷告可以改变一切事。
Recently, I have heard, I've learned a new song. The lyrics is very good.
最近我学习了一首诗，那首诗歌的歌词非常好。
In the future, if we have chance, we can learn this song together.
或许在未来，我们可以一起学习这首诗。
But the lyrics goes like this.
歌词是这样的。
Sometimes in our life, that we face a lot of frustration.
有时候我们对生活中的一切感到无力、沮丧。
Sometimes in our life, there's a lot of hidden sin.And hidden corruption.
有时候我们心中潜藏着诸多罪恶与堕落。
Sometimes we are proud and we lost direction.
有时候我们骄傲矜夸，失去了方向。
Our heart is so weak, we cannot get out of this kind of sadness.
我们心里软弱，不能自拔。
But what should we do?
不过我们要怎么做呢？
We have to return.
这时候要回头。
Seek God.
寻求神。
In your heart.Can be enlightened by Lord Jesus.
让心被耶稣照亮。
Because prayer can change everything.
因为祷告可以改变一切的事。
And when your heart is not peaceful, when you face trouble,
当你感觉不平静，生活处处是困境。
The moment you kneel down before the Lord, He will open a way.
只要屈膝向他求，神将路开启。
Prayer change everything.
祷告改变一切事。
But only when we humble ourselves.
不过只有在我们谦卑下来的时候。
Let's sing hymn 506.
我们一起来唱赞美诗506首。